Watched that early match, and I might give you the result of that one. In the interstate Aboriginal fixture, the under-17s, Queensland, New South Wales. New South Wales won it 14-10. Queensland led 10-0 at half-time. Fritted away the chance in the second half.
They sure did, Bill. A bit disappointing for the young Queenslanders, but I think it'll be a different story tonight in the main game. But it is good to see that the New South Wales people finally have got behind their team for such a long time. Queensland crowds have dominated the atmosphere of State of Origin. Well, New South Wales have turned it around tonight. There's nothing like night football. The Sydney Football Stadium has got a great atmosphere. The crowd is really getting into a frenzy in great expectation. Bill, the press here in Sydney, the media, have made New South Wales the favourites for this match. They're absolutely paranoid about the 8-loss sequence they've had down here, and they're really keen to see New South Wales take out a victory. But I think what they're forgetting is that New South Wales undoubtedly have far more pressure on them than Queensland. They've been made favourites. They're sitting on an 8-match losing sequence, but they've had less experience. The coach is under pressure. He had 3 losses last year, Jack Gibson. It is a fairly experienced New South Wales side in terms of club football, but they're far less experienced at the State of Origin level. I think Queensland will come in a lot smoother.
All right, talking about the atmosphere, I should imagine Tony Durkin down on that touchline with 40,000, well, almost 40,000 screaming New South Welshmen in your ear. It must be something.
Certainly is, Bill. The atmosphere down here is unbelievable. When the Sydney Football Stadium was first built a few years ago, there was a lot of criticism about the lack of atmosphere here, particularly when the stadium isn't full. Believe me, it is full tonight, and the atmosphere is unbelievable. So noisy, in fact, you can hardly hear yourself think. I'm sure that won't happen, though, when the footballers get out there. They'll know what they've got to do. The conditions are superb for rugby league. A very cool night in Sydney tonight, and I'm sure the players will love that. There's hardly a breeze to speak of, and obviously the kicking game from both sides is going to be vital, but the wind certainly will play no part in that whatsoever.
Interesting enough, when I was outside the stadium a short time ago, we did the cross from there, Fordo, there was quite a bit of wind out there, but obviously you just can't get into this stadium, so that's probably well and good.
Well, when it does, it circulates around in here, and I can tell you, Billy, this crowd is in a frenzy. They know that it's up to this side. You can see coming out the New South Wales team. It's do or die here tonight for them, and Benny Elias becomes the ninth New South Wales captain in the 10 years of Origin football. He leads the Blues out. They have won the toss here tonight.
Here they come, the New South Wales side. I'll let the crowd tell the story.
But New South Wales winning the toss, they can elect which end they wish to run from, and they will receive the football. Queensland will kick off. I wouldn't be surprised to see New South Wales put it back very early in the tackle count. They picked a highly defensive forward pack with Bruce Maguire, Gillespie, Roberts, Elias and Roach. There's Elias G'ing up his players. There'll be plenty of fire early. I don't think a lot of illegalities. I think we've seen the end of that sort of state. New South Wales certainly fired up.
By the way, too, tonight, let's welcome our viewers through DDQ up there in Toowoomba, MBQ, SEQ, RTQ and QTV in Townsville. In other words, we're going right throughout Queensland tonight. And there's Ian Roberts. He's one of the men that will play quite a part of this match tonight.
He sure will, Bill. One of the key players. There's one of the debutants in Ricky Walford. But Roberts, I think, is one of the key players. Another debutant on the wing in Rod Wishart. Getting back to Roberts, I think he's the key forward. Very hard to knock over. And there's the Queensland dressing room. Wally Lewis walks out in his civvies.
And there's Tosser Turner, the manager, and led out by Paul Vaughton, the second time that he's led the Maroons. The last time was when Wally was injured back in 1988. Following him is Mal Meninga. Fatty Vaughton, Billy, leading this side out on his new home ground, Eastern Suburbs home ground, the Sydney Football Stadium.
And he's only missed 4 matches, and the 4 matches that he has missed, Queensland lost those, so his record is pretty much intact.
Some dispute of whether Vaughton or Mal Meninga should have been captain in the absence of Wally Lewis. I agree with Vaughton's selection here, but one thing for sure and certain, Vaughton must go flat out all the way. If necessary, if he has to be replaced, he gets a bit tired. There's some great backup there with Gary Coyne and Trevor Gilmeister.
Billy, no need to say that we are playing this match at the Sydney Football Stadium by that welcome for the Queenslanders onto the ground.
Yeah, there's no risk about that. And talking about key men in the match tonight, there's one of them on centre screen right now, big Mal Meninga.
He is the key man for Queensland. He's the guy, no matter what defensive patterns they might want to set up, if Mal decides to go, 3 and 4 won't stop him.
There's little Alfie Langer. I guess the folks of the Brisbane Broncos will be keeping an eye on him tonight. I'm sure the New South Wales team will be. And there's the total appearances now in the team so far as State of Origin is concerned. So experience from a Queensland point of view really outweighing New South Wales there.
And Billy, the sole survivor from 1980 in appearance tonight is that man, big Mal Meninga. What a key player he'll be tonight. He's the leading point scorer in Origin history with 127 points. And we're waiting now for the national anthem here at the Sydney Football Stadium. It's a big moment for another Queenslander. I talk to the referee, David Manson. Football stadium this is under lights at night, and it is jam-packed to the rafters tonight. There's David Manson, made his debut here in the second match of the 1989 season, and coincidentally, David, that was the night that we saw that marvellous fight back by Queensland to clinch the series.
Yes, fantastic effort. Manson will be under pressure tonight, there's no doubt about that. The New South Wales players will try and test him out.
And fittingly, the man to kick the ball into the new era of Origin football is the man that was there on day one back in 1980, Mal Meninga. It will be New South Wales to defend the southern end of the Sydney Football Stadium. And straight away, Andrew Enninghouse and Feach Roberts. And up there is Paul Horton. Going into dummy half is Ben Elias. Tremendous play by Bradley Clyde to take play beyond the quarter line. Elias working open side. Big roaches, well met by Fullerton, Smith, Langer and Linder. Three plays gone by the Blues. Instill inside the corner. They can't afford to take their eyes off this man. Elias, a beautiful ball. But the defensive shearer is there. Langer came in for the second tackle. The ball's gone forward. So the good break has been let down by New South Wales. You cannot take your eye off him, David.
Yeah, and Alan Langer was the one who did take his eye off him. Thinking the kick was on, he went through to try and harass the kicker. Elias was away.
Scrum feed by New South Wales on the halfway line. A big drive by Queensland. It's a Queensland ball from Hagen. It goes out to Meninga, and the big man tried to stand in the tackle. But up there quickly was Mark McGaugh, working again towards that short side. Swarming defence by New South Wales. Right on the halfway line. No quarter given in this. Referee Manson keeping a good five on each side of the ruck. Langer, it goes out to Hagen, the good cutout pass. Belchers in the line, taken strongly in the tackle. Tremendous defence by New South Wales in the early minutes of this game. Now they move it to Bella. That's his first touch. And the big Manly prop forward puts his head down. Final tackle in this first set of six for Queensland. This is an important aspect of the game. Meninga has been taken out late.
And he pointed his finger at Elias, said, "You do that again and it's on, mate."
Well, the first bit of anger has been shown. And the game is just 2 minutes old.
And might I add, David, he's not the man to do it to.
No, I think he's a very brave man, Benny Elias.
Interesting so far. The game has been very open. Both sides prepared to throw the ball around.
And as I mentioned, speaking to David Manson before the game, no special instructions, David, to the two captains. Benny Elias asked, was there any special instructions? He said no. Paul Horton's question was how he was going to referee the scrums with infringements.
Well, I think both teams know exactly how it should be done. They're the best players in the world, and the referee shouldn't need to lecture them.
Now it's taken away by Les Kiss. Back in representative football after a four-year break. Belcher got the pass away, taken upfield this time by Meninga. And the crowd love that. The big fellow is wrapped up in the four-man tackle by New South Wales. There's Walters out of dummy half.
David, I think the crowd here love anything that happens out there at the moment.
Horton, yes, I agree. There's the good break. Tremendous play by Hagen, turning it back to Fullerton Smith. But coming across in defence was Gillespie. That's Horton, the dummy half. They move it to Langer. Queensland on the attack, 25 metres out from the New South Wales line. Let's see what the tactics will be on the final tackle. Debutant Steve Walters to dummy half. It'll go high in the air. Horton was the man that put it up.
Lindner took it, but he's offside. Been ruled offside.
Correct decision. Actually, it was a poor kick by Queensland. Vorton put the kick up. Lindner was always in front of him, and Vorton made no attempt at all to come through and put his players onside. There's Bobby Lindner well in front of the kicker. He does take it well, but at no stage was he behind the kicker, and New South Wales get a relieving penalty.
So it's Andrew Enninghausen tonight in that fullback role, playing in his eighth game in Origin football. Six as a winger, one as a centre. And he made his debut, Dave, in that last win by New South Wales in 1987. So wins have been few and far between for the Cronulla superstar.
Yes, he's an electrifying ball runner in Queensland. When they do get to kick downfield, to Enninghausen, who's playing fullback tonight, will need to have some good chases.
There's the run by Roberts. His big strength is to stand and unload, and that's exactly what he's done. The pass goes back from Daly to McGaugh. And there's some savage defence out there on both teams. And going low that time was Walters. Now the run by Roach, and Lindner wraps him up with Bella. Fullerton Smith was low and affected the tackle. Now the crisscross move, Elias again out of dummy half. That time the Queensland defence read it. Just inside their own half, the New South Wales. And Ricky Stewart will play such a vital role in that kicking game tonight. That's an excellent kick. Les Kitts allows it to bounce, picks it up nicely. He's 32 out from his own goal line.
Second kick in a row to go to Les Kitts.
Maybe they sense he could be a bit nervous, David, after a four-year break in Origin football.
There's been good pressure, though, on Ricky Stewart. He hasn't been able to get a clean kick away.
Quite interesting, the original plan that Ricky Walford was to mark Alan McAdoo, but I noticed, Billy, that that situation has been changed.
Yes, at this stage it's Les Kitts out there, and that'll be an interesting tussle in itself. But I thought if McAdoo had it marked, he would have made it a little bit more interesting.
Walters gives it away to Lindner, then to Fullerton-Smith. Oh, that's great defence. So leading the charge for Gillespie.
Big hits.
They call him cement, and I think he would have felt the full brunt of that. There's the big kick downfield. Retreating is Enninghausen, and he fielded it beautifully, and that will be great for his confidence.
It
a
will.
Good chase there by Queensland.
Perfect chase. They had four men coming up in the two halves. So important. Both Hagen and Langer do the chasing.
Langer out of dummy of the marker position, wraps up Wishart. New South Wales under pressure in their own quarter. Oh, what a good bit of defence by Staines coming across on Michael O'Connor. Play inside the quarter. We've had just on 5.5 minutes of the first half. Roach taken high that time by Martin Bella. Well, sitting in the grandstand doing it tough is Wally Lewis. Wally, your thoughts on the first 5 minutes?
Well, it's obviously been a helter-skelter the first couple of minutes there, David. Neither side's giving an inch. I've been fairly impressed with that last set of six tackles by Queensland. It really gave us a little bit of confidence here. Alan Langer had a perfect chasing game. We had a very good chasing line down there, and we managed to contain them for four tackles, and they only made about 8 or 10 metres. That's what we're really looking for at the moment, to pin them as deeply in their half as we possibly can. But as the game's only early at the moment, we've just got to hope that we can contain New South Wales, keep them down there, and also control the football ourselves, and we're in possession.
OK, enjoy it. We'll be back to you later in the match. Wally Lewis joining us in the stand alongside Coach Arthur Beetson. And they'll do it as tough as they will out on the field tonight with the players, David.
They will. Thought it'd almost be harder for Wally Lewis. But so far, Queensland have had territorial advantage. Basically, the game has been played in New South Wales' half. They'll enjoy that as long as they can keep New South Wales inside their own territory.
Well, one of our main concerns was the kicking game of Queensland, but so far it's been in pretty good order.
It has. The New South Wales are trying to attack the kicks, but Queensland varying kickers. Meninga's taken a couple, and also they put pressure on both Elias and Stewart.
Now Benny Elias tries to work across that side. 7 minutes gone in this first half, and the crowd still haven't got back in their chairs. It's been a constant pitch all the way through as the ball is popped out by Maguire. A long pass from Stewart, it goes to Daly, and Daly tries to break through the first line of defence, but he was wrapped up very well by Hagen. Good work by Hagen. Now taking it away is Michael O'Connor. Beautiful ball. There's Bradley Clyde, fullback to beat his Canberra teammate. It goes back, forward pass was it, and the referee denies Ricky Walford a try on debut. He was right on the spot to award it. Good refereeing by the Queenslander.
Perfect stuff. Here's Gillespie looking for support. He finds Walford. What a break from Bradley Clyde off a Michael O'Connor pass. Queensland a bit thin in midfield.
Well, the scrum will pack down inside the quarter. Queensland sucking the big breaths. They were under pressure. And New South Wales denied by a forward pass. Now Belcher got the pass away to Shearer. And he was well and truly wrapped up by McGaugh. Frantic pace, the first 9 minutes of this opening match of the 1990 season.
Test here for the Queensland forward pack. Can they go forward in this area of the ground? So important.
Dan Staines hit it up on tackle number three. Now it's Martin Bella. He's got a huge responsibility in that regard tonight. Steve Waters on to Moudinai, taking over his brother Kerrin. Spotted the gap, but not quite the place of Benny Elias. Here's the final tackle. Will it go to Meninga? Will it go to Belcher? Oh, that's a bad mistake. So position will turn over to New South Wales, and they are in an ideal attacking position. A messy play the ball. That's Roberts who will play it now to Elias. Now it will go to Stewart, the long pass to Daly. Daly to Bradley Clyne. He's going to do a lot of damage out wide. Reminiscent of Gene Miles, David.
He's devastating Bradley Clyde, and he's got all the skills, Prince, and they're going to have to watch him very closely.
Well, the man to watch in this set now is Ricky Stewart, but the penalty will go against the team in possession, and the crowd don't like it.
Not getting up to play the ball correctly. Bradley Clyde was being held down. Michael Hagan it was, who was the tackler, and I should say Laurie Daly was held down. As he tried quickly to get to his feet, he wasn't able to do so. David Manson saw it as an incorrect play the ball. You must get to your feet, stand up and play the ball. He has not endeared himself to the New South Wales crowd. A relieving penalty for Queensland.
Well, certainly it's a big home crowd advantage here tonight. 40-odd thousand on standby for this match tonight. But their record in Sydney, Queensland, has been excellent. They've won six of the nine since 1982. And Billy, the two appearances here at the Sydney Football Stadium have seen success go to Queensland. 10 minutes gone in this first half. We've still got a cracker of a match on our hands here tonight.
Certainly happened, as I was saying a short time ago, some big hits coming in, and there's another one on that occasion.
Here it is again, Bill. Staines, Roberts hits him with everything bar the kitchen sink. They stop dead in their tracks.
So it's Queensland about 8 metres inside New South Wales territory, away to Fullerton Smith. He gets to the 10-metre mark before the defence will wrap him up. Dummy half Walters to Langer. Alfie with a little grabber kick. He's following out after it. He takes it on the toe. He got it pushed away a little bit, I feel, on that occasion. Referee Manson says play on. New South Wales come away with it and end up midway between the quarter and halfway via the hands of Andrew Eddinghouse. And this is Wolford. 10 metres short of the halfway mark. Bit thin out on the left there. So Elias gets it away. Cutting up there is Roach. Roach with a getting knocked out with a nice tackle there. Steve Waters slowly getting back onto his feet. Looking around for support, there's plenty of it too. Coming through over there was Roberts. He sends a pass outside. O'Connor, can he get it back inside? I wish he can, but he's lost the ball. Going to be picked up by Queensland. Can they run it out? Yes, they can.
New South Wales, there's Wally Lewis and also Artie Beetson. They'd be very, very concerned at the moment. Here's the pass back on the inside, Michael O'Connor. Wishart got tackled as he tried to handle the ball, lost it forward. Good work from Bob Linder, takes it inside his own in-goal area and does well to bring it out.
So work they've got to do. That's Michael Hagan taking it up.
Well, Bill, what they've got to do is the hard work. I think Queensland a little bit prone to be a bit fancy early. New South Wales have got the upper hand at the moment. There's no substitute for hard work.
Martin Bella gets it up almost to the quarter line. Alan Langer drops in as the dummy half as Walters is taking a little bit of time to get himself together. So that'll be Staines taking it up again. So now a kick downfield by Meninga. Back there is Andrew Eddinghouse, and it bounces up nicely for him eventually. Plenty of Maroons up there to take care of him, and down he goes. Nice tackle by Linda. Wolford is the dummy half, and it's going to be a penalty, New South Wales.
Going on a little bit too much with the tackle there, Les Kiss, and New South Wales after a good kick downfield. Eddinghausen was had his legs cut from underneath him by Bobby Lindner, and a relieving penalty for New South Wales. They're going to take a bit of a breather. The game has been played at a really hectic pace. New South Wales undoubtedly with the advantage at the moment.
No points on the board as yet here at the Sydney Football Stadium. And there's the kick for touch by Eddinghausen. It'll come up to 15 metres short of the halfway mark.
Penalties favour New South Wales by 2-1.
Elias from the tap. Doubling around over there is Wolford. Wolford going to be knocked over. Tony Durkin touchline.
Steve Walters, the report from the bench on Steve Walters is that he's just a little groggy. I'm sure a few players will be before the night's out. Walters OK to keep going.
Ricky Stewart gets up to play it now. They swing it away. And that's Laurie Daly.
New South Wales using a lot of cross runners at the back of the ruck to try and confuse the Queensland defenders.
Wishart comes up as dummy half. And New South Wales get it to the halfway mark or just inside. Elias trying to work it across field. They don't get too far. Eventually going to ground with it that time will be Bruce McGuire. Final tackle. Up she goes by Ricky Stewart. Back there. Harry Belcher waiting for it. It's moving around a little bit, but he takes it. and carking away from Bradley Clark, who knocks him over.
Well taken by Belcher, showed good technique. Look how he just puts the body to the side, protects the ball, makes sure McGaugh can't get at it, and does it neatly.
Yeah, he went up pretty high too, because Stewart can put him up very, very high and really test out those fullbacks.
Billy, the work rate of the two second rowers for New South Wales, Maguire and Gillespie, in defence has been outstanding.
Here's Alan Langan with it. They keep it going. Now that New South Wales defence just gnawing away, and they're finding it very difficult to get out of that 22-metre side of the field. This is Martin Bella. He does a little bit better on that occasion, Bella. Walters from dummy half, swings it away to Meninga, out to Belcher this time. He'll drive it down between Ettinghausen and Wishart. It rolls back over the quarter line. Ettinghausen back there, there's plenty of chases. Wishart will be the one to take it. And Wishart is put down just on the quarter line. Well, that's more like it, David.
Good kick, good chase. They took a double play to get the kick away, and good effort from Belcher to put it downfield.
Well, they're obviously going to use Meninga at times, but on that occasion, swung it away over there to Belcher. Crowd starting to rev up. They're looking for a penalty here. Benny Elias with it. They keep it going. Nice work. Roach coming up the centre. He unloads it to Elias, doubling around again. There's a bit of problems coming up if they get it wide. Daly swings it away this time, cutting his way through over there. This time is O'Connor. O'Connor to Wolfe, and he kicks through, following out after it. And Les gets back there in the in-goal area.
It will be a penalty. Correct decision. Ricky Walford was taken out of play after he put the kick in. Gary Belcher, I think it was. Meninga couldn't get across and cover defence. Beautiful little kick this from Walford. The ball does sit in the in-goal area. And Belcher decided that he was not going to allow Ricky Walford past him. A professional penalty. Perhaps in the Sydney Rugby League could have incurred a five-minute stint in the sin bin. But a penalty will suffice in David Manson's judgment. And Michael O'Connor, it would appear, will have a shot for 2 points.
So now there's a shot of the huge crowd here at the Sydney Football Stadium tonight. They've had plenty to cheer about. This New South Wales side have really put their shoulder to the wheel tonight, first up. New South Wales second rowers have got through 15 tackles already in this match.
Look at the angle that Michael O'Connor's going to take this kick, Bill. Is he going to kick for goal, or is he going to put it across the face of goal?
Well, he's got a bit of each way here, Fordo. It's a Jack Gibson tactic that they've used in the past when he used to coach Cronulla. Now, all the players are well out on the open side there. If he gets it through the goal, it's 2 points. I think Queensland have stacked too much in front of Michael O'Connor. They have not got enough players on the far side for mine.
There it goes. He kicks for goal. He hasn't stuck it through, but they're flying through. It's going to be Queensland caught in the in-goal area, but took it on the full. No.
There was a bit of two players touched it, Bill, but you cannot be offside in your own in-goal area. Have a look at it here. The ball bounces forward. There's Shearer catching the ball. Cannot be offside in your own in-goal area. The crowd was calling for a penalty. No chance.
But it's Queensland with a drop out from underneath the goal now. So the pressure remains.
Well and truly on for Queensland.
Drop it out again.
You just wonder whether you put that down as a missed goal to Michael O'Connor, Bill, whether that was a set play.
Yeah, well, it certainly looked that way, didn't it? That's Bradley Clyde with it. Elias from dummy half. Ettinghausen embalming himself, and Alan Langer is the tackler. Elias again, that's Roach. And it was Alfie underneath again, back to Elias. Almost a gap, but Bella's there. The pass goes back behind Ettinghausen. Going to be dived on by Staines. It's a Maroons ball, and by golly, they needed it.
Langer calls it quickly. He wants to move it straight away.
And that's Fatty Wharton out wide with him, and he cuts back inside. Putting a fence over there to take him on. Dummy half is Walters. Nil all the score. Fullerton Smith knocked over. 30 metres out from the Queensland line. To Alan Langer. Belcher into it now. Belcher trying to find a way around, but no chance. Tackler over there is Ricky Stewart. Kiss from dummy half. No chance. Put down by Gillespie. Final tackle, so back to Meninga. Chased out over there by Elias. He did some good work and put him off the kick. Ettinghausen's back there, allows it to run past him. Now he picks it up. He starts to move, but Michael Hagan will be the tackler. There's Wally Lewis and Arthur Beetson. They'd be pretty concerned, I'd imagine, at this stage. But a long, long way to go. That's Wishart. Bang, in goes Bobby Lindner. Lindner puts him over, 30 metres out from the New South Wales line. A bit of kicking going on at this stage. Queensland, 7 occasions, New South Wales, 4. But Queensland struggled on the last one, but Elias persisted in coming at Mal Meninga, and that's be their ploy, I guess.
It will, Bill. And Queensland need to up their tempo a bit in defence. They're allowing New South Wales too much latitude.
See, there's Elias slipping across field again. but eventually put down by Dale Shearer over the top, and coming in underneath is Walters. Now let's have a look at this. Laurie Daly's going to be the kicker this time. Back there is Gary Belcher. He runs onto it up over the quarter line. Across field to try and get away from Laurie Daly, who kicked it, followed through, and he did the job. Put him down. There's Kiss away from dummy half. This is Hagen. Ollie Lewis and Arthur Beaton up there, having a chat to Sydney. Queensland moving it to 10 metres short of that halfway mark. So it's 18 and a half minutes of the match gone so far. This is Meninga. He sends it right over the top. So far away it goes into touch.
Queensland definitely being frustrated. The opportunity was there, but Meninga looking for the pass that was not executed at all well. There's the brains trust of the Queensland team, and they would be very concerned at the moment. New South Wales have the upper hand.
So now into the scrum. Tony Durkin, I think they showed Wally on the screen here, and he got a boo without even being on the field, didn't he?
Yes, he got the typical Wally Lewis reception in Sydney. The big boos went up for Walter.
Well, at least he didn't pay to get in like some of them, I guess. In by Stewart to Daly. Look at Ettinghausen lurking up there, and also going through. Honor goes to Wishart. McGaugh ran running, went through on that occasion over there also to take away the attention from Ettinghausen. Wishart about 8 metres inside Queensland territory. That's Laurie Daly, but he's going to be wrapped up. Elias is the dummy half. Eventually turns it away, going around over there that time was Ian Roberts. Elias, they'll work the blind side. And Roach coming through, but he's bowled over 25 metres out. New South Wales keeping up the pressure. So at this stage, we're halfway through the first half and there are no points on the board.
But New South Wales in a great effort to attack here. Beautiful defence by Meninga and O'Connor. Now Daly goes to dummy half. It's on the final tackle. And it's been knocked, it's been touched inside. They're all onside. A chance for New South Wales. Clyde, beautiful pass for Elias. And he's a metre short. Six tackles to go for New South Wales. Queensland in desperate defence. Clyde, beautiful cut-out pass. Ettinghausen takes it and take it into touch. Desperate defence by Dale Shearer. The second big hit on Ettinghausen in the space of a minute.
It's hard to see how Queensland saved the day there. Perhaps that pass that went to ground was the saving grace. Ettinghausen couldn't handle. Dale Shearer shoved him into touch. Absolute desperation. New South Wales have bombed a couple of tries.
I called it a good pass initially from Clyde because I thought the idea was good, but there was really no need. They had the numbers on the outside, David.
You're right, Porto. There was an indication of pack weights there. Queensland have a heavier pack than New South Wales, but they're not exploiting the advantage.
Now Littner, 11 metres out from his own goal line, and Queensland have been under enormous pressure. But they have weathered it. Scoring opportunities gone astray for Ettinghausen, Wishart, and Ricky Walford. Now the long pass, good defence by New South Wales. That's forced the error, but it's allowed them to attack out wide. Paul Vorton got the pass away to the flying McIndoe, and he did beautifully to hang on to it. McIndoe gets to play the ball. Oh, there's the knock on in dummy half.
Second time Queensland have made a bad error from the dummy half position. Just trying to rush things a little bit. Dale Shearer, the offender there, moving out of the dummy half position, not concentrating. And this is allowing New South Wales to keep the pressure on.
Tony Durkin.
Poise from Queensland tonight, David. One of the poise from Queensland tonight was for quick play the balls. Maybe they're executing it a little too quickly for the dummy half.
It could well be. New South Wales now with Daly running across field. The long pass for Ricky Walford. Walford with the kick and chase. He's got a great ability in this part of his game. But Queensland saved the day again with Gary Belcher.
Another tactic noticeable from New South Wales is the width that Laurie Daly is standing away from Ricky Stewart. He's got one of the best passes in the game, Ricky Stewart, and Jack Gibson is utilising that to get a great deal of width in attack.
Well, it's an important year for Stewart with the Kangaroo Tour at the end of the year. It's going to be a marvellous battle with he and Alan Langer in this series.
It's happened again. A little knock on at the dummy half. Queensland three times. This is just handing it on a plate to New South Wales. And when I say that, it's the pressure. Not to be too much wrong with it in replay.
Well, I don't know what that was all about. That appeared to be quite okay, but it's given loose head and feed to New South Wales. Inside, look how deep they are in attack. It'll go to Stewart, the wide pass again to Daly. Daly tries to straighten, but then he runs across field and got it back infield. And O'Connor was beautifully picked off at the tackle by Belcher. New South Wales centre field on the quarter line. Stewart got the pass away to Clyde, the two Canberra teammates combining to take play across that 22-yard line. Elias calling the troops to run onto this football inside the attacking quarter. Now big blocker Rhodes takes it upfield. But the Queensland defence is equal to the task. Turning it over now. The dummy Elias. There he goes again. It's back for Ettinghausen. And meeting him in the defence was Paul Horton.
Great tackle.
Elias has been really involved. Stewart, the pass out to Bradley Clyde. And another good bit of defence this time from Dan Staines. Wasn't no, it was Fullerton Smith. They move it to Stewart. There's the high ball on his Canberra teammate, Gary Belcher. But it comes across field. Picked up by Walford. Langer gets there to meet him. And that should be the turnover of possession. Once again, Queensland weathered the storm. And they've taken play outside the quarter.
Well, we've had 24 minutes in the match so far, Forday. Queensland have been disadvantaged. There's another error at the play the ball. David Manson adjudicating there that it was simply lost by Queensland and not stolen by New South Wales. And once again, the New South Welshmen with another good chance to go straight on the attack.
Well, they've just put pressure right back on themselves. And the big question mark is, can New South Wales now turn that pressure into points? Stewart again. Look at the length of that pass back for Ettinghausen. A variation from the scrum base on that occasion. 14 errors to 4. Queensland have been guilty of in this first half. And it's so unlike them.
And what it does too, Forda, all this defence saps your strength. So Queensland are going to have to call on all the reserves.
Although, on the other hand, David, if New South Wales can't turn it into points, it can really take the wind out of their sails as well.
Certainly can be frustrating.
Now Elias works the blind side with Rhodes, but it's constant pressure. Wishart, tremendous defence by McIndoe. And Bruce McGuire down injured in back play.
Well, for taking Wishart into touch after the tackle had been affected, it was a good tackle, that one from McIndoe. And there's the second shove, also assisted by Shearer. Another chance for New South Wales.
That's silly stuff. McGuire down getting attention. And he's injured the back. Elias just knocks it into touch, but he sucks the big breaths in, Bruce McGuire. And now, once again, Queensland are forced to defend. Stewart, a beautiful little play again with Elias. They are the two danger men around the edge of the ruck. Don't take your eye off him or Stewart all night. Queensland defence working overtime. Penalty. Tony Durkin on the sideline, you saw it.
Yes, certainly Steve Rhodes, the player at fault. He obviously thought he got one in a tackle. He retaliated right in front of referee David Manson. What a stupid thing to do. New South Wales in possession and Roach has given away a penalty.
Well, you could see there on the replay that Roach was definitely the offender. Vorton was the one who retaliated. There's the missed tackles. Queensland a massive 9 to New South Wales 0. But certainly New South Wales have had the majority of possession.
But 26 minutes of play gone in the first half and New South Wales have yet to turn all that pressure into points. Queensland hanging on by the skin of their teeth at the moment. After a very bright start, there's another loss of possession and New South Wales back with the football through the hands of David Gillespie. They're 5 metres inside Queensland's end of the ground. The long pass again. Stewart was cut out there. Oh, that's a dreadful pass from Stewart. That was an absolute shocker, trying to pass on the wrong side.
Yeah, I even think he tried to flick it. Let's have a look as he fades across field. Thought about flicking, had the ball out in front, lost it. But Queensland have lost it again.
So New South Wales come back with the ball inside their own half. Daly a dummy half. Got it away this time to McGuire. He's back on his feet after that injury. Elias calling for it now on the centre of the halfway line. Queensland move up very quickly in defence. And they move up on Robertson, take him ball and all. No points on the board. 27 minutes of play gone in this first half. The pass back in for Gillespie. Elias, midway between the half and the 22. It's at Queensland's end of the ground. The Canberra halves of Stewart and Daly combined beautifully. Daly in the space. The pass out this time, O'Connor. That pass is forward. So they've bombed another one.
Well, Queensland haven't played to the whistle either. But there's a great relief. Wally Lewis and Artie Beetson cannot believe it. Daly shows his pace. Michael O'Connor threw this ball forward. The player was in an offside position for mine. Should never have been only a forward pass. Should have been a penalty to Queensland.
So the scrum will pack down 10 metres out. Alan Langer sucks in the deep breaths. They've been under enormous pressure, the Maroons. Now Les Kitts comes in off the right wing.
And the big question here, David, is can they hold him for the 6 tackles?
Well, he's burst up Bill to take it to the quarter line. The handling errors, surprisingly, Queensland the culprits by just 1.
Well, New South Wales, obviously, with all the possession that they've had, have given away some key handling errors. Queensland haven't held the ball for long. New South Wales have held it for longer, but ultimately have frittled away at least four try-scoring opportunities.
Yes, four that I can recall right off the top of my head. And that last one from a forward pass, just unbelievable stuff. So I suppose, David, it comes down to what this pressure of origin football is all about. That is really telling on these players. Remembering that New South Wales are fielding four new players out there tonight. And, of course, Queensland, the underdogs.
Yeah, touch in flight.
Two players down, injured. Eddinghausen runs sideways, pushed out by Shearer, and Wishart links up with him. All the players back on their feet. Wally Lewis and Beetson again look on. It's been a tense 29 minutes for both sides. And territorially, it's been enjoyed by New South Wales, although it was a very confident start by the Maroons in the first 10 minutes. Billy, I don't know how this crowd keeps going. It hasn't stopped the noise here at the Sydney Football Stadium for 30 minutes.
Well, I've waited a long time to have something to cheer about.
Here goes Daly. Got the pass away to McGaugh. That pass was forward again. It's back for Eddinghausen. He got the pass away beautifully. Elias, the pass over the top. Ricky Walford tried to stand up the defence. Got it away. That's a try to New South Wales. Beautiful pass. And I think it's McGaugh. Berserk. And Mark McGaugh opens the scoring.
They had to
watch
wait
it in replay.
They had to wait for a long time. Finally, Laurie Daly once again does well to get his hands on the outside. Have a look at this. Just in beside the defence. I thought Vorton had done well to get to McGaugh. Now McGaugh was tackled there. Actually gets up to score this try. Eddinghausen bounces out of one tackle. Good pass up to Elias. Ricky Walford then has to receive the ball and beat Alan Langer. He then gets caught from behind. There's Belcher, but great pass up. Brilliant hands, McGaugh. He bounces across the try line. No semblance of a double movement. From the corner camera, this will look great. Here's Laurie Daly, takes on the defence, creates the opening for Mark McGaugh. Back on the inside, Eddinghausen. Langer goes high and can't make the tackle. There's the follow-up one, though, by Les Kiss. Always backing up is Benny Elias. The over-the-top pass. Ricky Walford gets away from Alan Langer, but not from Belcher, who came late. There's the bouncing try. New South Wales finally get a reward.
4-0 to New South Wales.
So this is Walters getting up towards the quarter line. Queensland fighting back but losing the ball again. Elias breaking away with it. Langer goes at him. They keep it going. This is Stewart. He sends it outside. Waiting and weaving and dodging over there, but the defence coming in, and that was Laurie Daly going over in it.
There's the replay of the conversion of the try. A great kick from Michael O'Connor. Knocked it over from the sideline. New South Wales lead by 6-0.
So waiting now for the play the ball. Daly is the player, Laurie Daly, the one down injured, and couldn't play the ball, so the play went on from there.
Missed tackles are a telling statistic, Bill. 11 by Queensland and only one by New South Wales.
Round the corner beautifully. New South Wales on the muscle again. Going to ground with it up there is Bruce McGuire. But a penalty, New South Wales.
Well, this is frustration from Queensland now. They've made a number of errors themselves at the play the ball movement. Here trying to slow down New South Wales. What a pass by Steve Rates to get it away.
The other day, wasn't he outrageous?
Oh, yeah, talk about blind.
Yeah, he couldn't see the end of his nose.
Not even if it was lit up with a beacon.
A bacon?
No wonder he had egg all over his face.
McMuffin?
No, that's not his name.
New South Wales getting 5 penalties to 2 so far in this match. And they're in possession about 25 metres out from the Queensland line. Tony Durkin.
I don't know what they've got to complain about, the New South Wales supporters. They want the grasshopper back, but they're in front, as you said, Bill, 5-2 in the penalties.
All right, here they go, trying to get a bit of action going now. That's Eddinghausen going to be pulled down. But they're keeping up the pressure again. Dummy half swings it away. This is Daly. Back onto his feet fairly quickly and eventually put down on the tackle. Final tackle. What will Elias do with it? It's played forward over there by Daly, but it's going to be a penalty, Queensland.
Let's have a look at it. not handling the ball in the ruck, perhaps. Let's have a look at it. Daly there touches it, plays it to the side. There's no reason you can't do that. If anything, he wasn't standing square on. It's certainly a relief for Queensland.
Malbeninga finds touch. That's a good kick. It's midway between the quarter and halfway. Lonnie Lewis and Arthur Beaton looking on, knowing that this Queensland team are under a fair amount of pressure out there.
Well, they've got 5 minutes, Bill, to get some points on the board in this first half. 6-0. New South Wales could easily have been a lot further in front than that. But Queensland need a bit of attacking ball to be able to do something, to use that brilliant back line.
Well, here's Fatty Wharton trying to do that. He gets just inside New South Wales territory, loses the ball, but a penalty. Taken out of his hands by Maguire, but a penalty, Queensland.
The crowd not happy with it, but there's Wharton being certainly having the ball stolen from him, ripped from him by Maguire. And a chance now for the Maroons.
Vinnie Elias had a bit to say to referee Manson on that occasion.
What he'd be asking there, Bill, is just when can you and when can't you steal the ball? Normally it is if the tackle has not been affected. And the New South Wales referees, at least the interpretation is, you can at least attempt to steal the ball.
Well, it's probably Benny being an assistant to the referee, as he normally is. So there's another big tackle coming in.
Silly.
Touch judge coming in. He took a while to make up his mind.
Well, it could be interesting, this, because Queensland are in possession. It would suggest that the penalty will go to New South Wales. Let's have a look at it. There was a punch by Bella. That is really stupid when you're in possession. And a report now, the touch judge to David Manson, right in front of Tony Durkin. How'd you see it, Tony?
Oh, certainly, Ben Martin Bella was the man at fault there. David Gillespie put a big hit on Martin Bella. Obviously said something to them as they went to ground, and Bella retaliated with a left hook. Ridiculous.
Dumb.
So he's being spoken to now by referee Manson, Fatty Wharton and Elias there clapping and saying, "We've got it, fellas." So the penalty to New South Wales, 30 metres out from their own line. 3 minutes remaining to the half-time break, and they have a lead of 6-0.
Queensland must hang on for dear life here now. 6-0 is retrievable. They cannot let New South Wales in to extend their lead.
So it's Andrew Eddinghausen to kick the touch. And it's going to find it just inside Queensland territory. So we'll wait for the play to go on from there. This is Warford working across field. That is going to be put to the ground over there. Fullerton Smith sliding it underneath. Elias away from dummy half. Going to be juggled a little bit over there by Roberts. But they keep it going. That's Ricky Stewart, 10 metres inside Brisbane or Queensland territory.
He's got that unbelievable ability to unload, Bill, hasn't he?
Well, there's Bradley Clyde. That looked a bit sus to me. He's sort of shuffling forward there to him. However, Elias with it. He'll send it outside then to Maguire. He keeps it going. Back to Elias. Still going. Still going is Elias. He's 20 metres out from the Queensland line. Good work for the New South Wales captain. From the play of the ball. They keep it going with Stewart outside to Daly. Swing it away to Wishart. Wishart takes it on the fly, but is smacked into the ground and he's into touch.
Good defence, Queensland. Whilst they've made a number of errors in attack, Queensland, their defence has been desperate. They'll need all the desperation they can get. There's Meninga assisting, and Wishart knocked in a touch.
Staines 14 tackles, Fullerton Smith 13, Gillespie 14. They're the top tackle counts in the first half of this match. 1.5 minutes to go, so the Maroons in possession. And we'll need to just run it out and hang on to it and take it up from here. That's Bob Lindner. Played forward, Lindner. Wrapped up though. So now, running it away is Hagen. Oh, a big tackle in over the top. That was Gillespie again. So he can rack up 15 tackles for him. Langer to Meninga. Little kick through. Came off a New South Wales player. Picked up by Walford. Walford decides to run it out up the centre. Just on a minute to go in this first half. Daly's up his dummy half. Daly takes it. Elias. There's the kick through. And this one's got a fine touch. 10 metres out from the Queensland line.
Well, that's not what Benny wanted. The shake of the head says it all. He wanted the kick there for Rod Wishart. And Wishart was flying through, and it could have been an interesting chase. But he doesn't get the bounce he was looking for. It goes into touch. It'll be loose head and feet. Queensland with only 30 seconds to go in this first half. Elias will look for a tight head if possible.
Unbelievable tactics on the second tackle, Bill.
Yes, my word it is. Particularly when they were on the attack and keep that pressure up. Coming into the half-time break, give it everything you've got. There's players out there, the both packs took a little while to get over to that mark, and I don't blame them. They'll be looking for this break. which comes up in 10 seconds from now. So the New South Wales lead is 6-0 coming into the half-time break. And a Queensland team who've done an enormous amount of defence out there. This is Bella. Bella to the quarter line. There's the hooter. And that brings us up to a sensational 40 minutes of play. And New South Wales go to the break. A lead here at the Sydney Football Stadium of 6-0.
Well, it's a New South Wales lead of 6-0 at the half-time break, David, and it's been pretty tough going out there.
I think players, spectators and commentators look forward to that half-time break, Bill. The pace has been absolutely frantic.
All right, talking about the half-time break, there's great entertainment coming up here at the Sydney Football Stadium. So we'll take you now to the State Bank Laser Show.
Into a try. Peter Sterling, I just wonder, so many opportunities for New South Wales, but just the 6 points.
Yes, but I think that will show later in the game as well. I'm going to make a big statement. I think Queensland are gone. I really think that first half performance by New South Wales, and this has been one of their great abilities, keeping the ball alive. We see Laurie Daly, who's had a super game. Mark McGaugh, maybe a touch forward, but who cares? Andrew Eddinghausen gets into the clear, throws a great ball to Benny Elias. And you can see Queensland, even their defence now, regrouping well. Ricky Walford got Langer in front of him, the big step. And just magnificent hands here from Mark McGaugh. That's epitomised New South Wales play, the backing up of the man, and that's where they are far superior to Queensland in the first 40 minutes.
But New South Wales have had all the possession, and Wayne Pearce, the defence from Queensland at times was outstanding.
It was. In fact, they've tackled well right across the paddock. Out in the backs, they've tackled well. In the forwards, they've tackled well. The only area that they've been let down is around the marker area. And that's where Benny Elias has made a few breaks, and I believe he'll come into his own in the second half.
Peter Sterling said they're gone. Queensland, are they gone?
I think it'll be difficult, but it's a strange game. New South Wales have had all the field position, all the ball, and you've only scored one try.
All right, well, it's 6-0 here at half-time. We're going to take a break and be back with more from the Sydney Football Stadium.
Well, David Wright, Peter Sterling says Queensland are gone. Do you agree?
Well, Bill, if they play the way like they did in the first half, they will be gone. There's no doubt about that. They need to turn things around. New South Wales have thoroughly outplayed them. 6-0, Queensland are lucky. I can't remember Queensland making a break. Now, I think they can turn around. They've got some good players to do it. But I also think Artie Beetson's got a couple of fresh forwards on the bench there that I'd be looking to use. Gary Coyne and Trevor Gilmeister. They need a bit more sting in the forwards because New South Wales are getting on top.
All right, here's some of the stats coming out of the match so far.
Well, there's the starts of play, and really there's not much in that in possession, right? 7-4 scrums in favour of Queensland, 6-4 the other way in penalties. So nothing at all in that. The possession is very interesting. New South Wales have had the more tackles in possession. Now, that means they've held it for a little bit longer. There hasn't been much in set pieces. The top tacklers, all the players basically doing their jobs. Gillespie, Maguire and Clyde, the forwards working pretty hard. Fullen, Smith, Staines and Bella. But Queensland need a bit more sting. They need to go forward. Any time the ball's got out into the back line, Queensland have been too flat. They've been very easily nullified, Meninga and Shearer. A lot of work to be done and better kicking in general play.
All right. Well, there was just one major highlight, I guess, for New South Wales supporters. That was the one try in the match so far.
Yeah.
And they did well, I thought, to eventually get there.
It was a good try, Bill. They worked very hard up until this time. Now, Laurie Daly's been dangerous. He's looked to try and get across field and set play up like that a few times. Eddinghausen breaks that tackle. Now, it's good backup play. New South Wales have got players all over the park. Elias elects to come back outside. Ricky Walford, some good footwork. And then that's a great pass. McGaugh does well to pick it up off his fingertips. That's good effort by New South Wales. But it must be remembered they must have at least four other chances, Bill, where they could have put points on the board.
Yeah, they certainly did mess up a few there. And I'd say Jack Gibson would be have a bit to say to them, I would imagine, at this halftime break.
Well, he would, Bill. But a lot of times things come together for them. You know, if you just keep trying, that last try is an indication of what they can do in the second half.
All right, well, talking about the second half, we'll take a break and be back with that in just a moment. Okay, here we are back at the Sydney Football Stadium getting ready for the second half of this opening match of the 1990
series for the State of Origin, and that'll give you an idea of this crowd. Well, they've had a fair bit to cheer about, but they had a fair few frustrations in that first half.
They did, Bill, but I think the majority of the crowd think they're on a winner here at the moment. But let's face it, Queensland have a good opportunity now to turn things around.
Our major sponsor, of course, is Air New Zealand for this match. And it's been played at a furious pace for the first half.
Unbelievable pace, and I think the reports from the dressing rooms at halftime are of vital importance, particularly if there are going to be changes, because the 26 players hit it at full pace. Tony Durkin, what's the news?
Well, the news from both dressing rooms is no changes, even though New South Wales showed a lot of concern at halftime for Bruce McGuire, who has a back injury. So Paul Sheridan was warming up. Don't be surprised to see Big Sheridan into the fray early. The Queensland dressing room, the message there was to look after Benny Elias. That was the initial message. They're not doing that. Support the ball carrier more in attack, Arthur Beetson wants from Queensland. He also wants them to get tighter in the middle of the ruck, the forwards. New South Wales are making too much room up in the middle of the ruck. And the other thing, of course, is more respect for possession. They gave away far too much ball in that first half to New South Wales.
Well, that message to look after Benny Elias probably shouldn't have had to be reminded at halftime. That message should have been loud and clear once that New South Wales time was chosen 10 days ago. But Queensland now with a job ahead of them. They trail by 6-0. And the pace of the first half. There's the fresh reserves. Little Jeff Toovey and big Paul Sheridan. We also have Lazarus. Very intelligent front row forward from the Canberra club. And played such a vital role the last time he was here. That was on grand final day when Canberra scored that historic victory. That man in picture was also involved, Gary Coyne and Kevin Walters, and young Mark Coyne on his right, and the man they call the axe, Trevor Gilmeister. Will we see Coyne and Gilmeister injected pretty soon into the second half? Referee David Manson blows time on in the second half. Michael O'Connor drives the ball deep towards the southern end of the football stadium. It's taken by Gary Belcher. First touch of the football of the second half for Les Kiss. And Bradley Clyde wrestles him back another 2 or 3 metres. Steve Walters a dummy half. And big Mal Meninga takes it upfield, just short of the quarter line. Walters again a dummy half, away for Bella. And that's a good run by Bella. Takes play past the quarter line. Walters again, looking for the runner in Staines. Cut him out and gave it to Fullerton Smith, but the Queenslanders lost 2 or 3 metres in that play. 4 tackles gone in this set. Meninga across to his Canberra teammate Gary Belcher into open space. Now he'll put the kick downfield. He'll put it across towards the wing of Rod Wishart. The chasers are up there for Queensland, but Wishart got away from Langer and also from Fullerton Smith. Now Stewart can be dangerous from the situation. Got the pass away. Henninghausen spill the football. Maybe that's the stroke of fortune that Queensland were looking for so early in this first half.
Well, fortune, certainly a great tackle it was. And Stephen Waller was the man who pulled off the tackle.
And Bobby Lindner takes the play 33 metres out from the New South Wales line. Their backs well offside. Referee Manson must spot that soon as they work it up towards the attacking quarter. Just a minute and a half gone in the second half. Now Hagen, long ball across field. One of the rare touches for Dale Shearer. He's been well and truly marked out there tonight. A danger man from broken players, Dale Shearer. Now they get it away for Dan Staines. Tourist to New Zealand last year after an outstanding series. Only played in 2 of the matches, but played superbly. Now Langer hoists it high in the air. Across field, the chase is on by Queensland. Shearer knocked it back, it's been knocked forward. But the Queenslanders have been ruled inside the 5.
Yeah, in front of Alan Langer, Dale Shearer disagreeing with it. He felt he stayed behind Alan Langer. Alan Langer actually did quite a bit of running, but it's always difficult for a referee to adjudicate on that one when it's hooked across the back of the ruck.
So New South Wales with the chance to drive it outside their quarter through their fullback, Andrew Henninghausen. But really, David has handled the fullback role pretty well tonight in this, what they call the cauldron of fire here at State of Origin, but he has had a wealth of experience in his early days with Cronulla and also with Leeds in the English Championship.
Yes, and Queensland have not placed a lot of pressure on him, so he's had a fairly dream run, and as you say, he's had a reasonable amount of experience.
Ricky Stewart tonight making his Origin debut. Trying to become the 38th dual international for Australia. The last one was Michael O'Connor. There's some tremendous defence. That's inspiring stuff by Bob Lindner.
Actually, it's been a good start for the Queenslanders here.
Bradley Clyde, solid defence here. I agree with you, Billy. They needed to start confidently, and they have.
I'd say that Arnie Beetson and Wally Lewis has given them an earful at half-time.
The kicking game of Ricky Stewart will play a prominent role in the second half. juggled by Gary Belcher, kept it under control all the time though, and runs it back towards halfway, but the chase is on by Michael O'Connor. Good defence by the Manly three-quarter. Les Kiss decides to give it a run. Well, Wally, what was the feeling like in the dressing room with the Queenslanders at halftime?
Well, they're a little bit quiet, David. Obviously, they're a little bit shell-shocked, and I think more than anything, they're a bit disappointed in their own performance. They knew that the big thing that we were missing, of course, was ball security, and we didn't have a very good chasing game out of the marker position. It's something that we've got to work on. Otherwise, we're going to be in big trouble because they just made too many clean breaks from around about the marker area, which certainly weren't kept in check at all.
Well, we'll come back to you in a moment because McAdoo puts it high in the air across towards Eddinghausen. He's been taken out, lost. Players ruled onside. It's a Queensland ball, but the referee will rule the knock-on. It'll be loose head and feet to New South Wales. Here it comes again in replay. The chase was always there. It was Hagen that came through. It's a Queensland loose head and feet. The knock-on rule against New South Wales. It goes across to Hagen. And now to Belcher, running wide. It's away with Shearer. Shearer got the tried to get the pass away, but the New South Wales defence was there. Now it goes with Horton Smith. Now Bobby Lindner it is, and takes it over the quarter line. And takes another 4 or 5 metres. Got the pass out the back door. Dan Staines taken in the tackle. Hagen got the pass away to Les Kiss. Kiss lost yardage. Got it to Fulton Smith. Delaying it. Queensland on the attack. Stepping run by Shearer. Through the dummy. Here's a chance. The ball's been knocked back. 6 to go. Bella got the pass away. Staines. And play by Queensland. Now they move it. Taken up by Paul Vaughton. Queensland line deep in attack. Bella goes blind. It goes open to Langer. It goes to Hagen. Now to Meninga. No, he holds onto the ball. Turned it back infield. Les Kiss coming in from the right wing. They're a little bit thin on the left. New South Wales. Queensland move it that way through Bella. Straightened it well. Got the pass. Fullerton Smith taken in the tackle. Now they move Langer. A little kick through. Beautifully fielded. Ricky Stewart tidies it up.
Well, there's disappointment from Wally Lewis. He realised that was an opportunity there for Queensland. They really needed to get that ball into the in-goal area. Wishart has lost it, but a penalty.
Well, they were about to sweep onto attack on this left-hand side, but the penalty will relieve pressure on New South Wales. Let's watch it.
There's the raking action. David Manson has been consistent. That's a penalty, one to each side.
So we've had 6 minutes of play gone in the second half.
There's the penalties, 8-4 in favour of New South Wales.
And no change to the halftime scoreline that saw New South Wales lead by 6-0. A try to McGaugh and a sensational conversion by Michael O'Connor.
6 minutes of the second half, we've seen more attack from Queensland in that passage of play than in the whole match.
And pressure from Queensland too. They've certainly gone up a gear. Wally Lewis cheering on. Dan Staines had moved in quickly, forcing errors from New South Wales.
Well, the whole pack got together then and said, OK, this is the break we wanted. Let's see what they can do with the Queensland. The ball fed by Langer, straight into the second row. Lindner off the back of the scrum. And the battle of the halfbacks continues there with Stewart and Langer. Now Lindner straightens it up beautifully, Bobby Lindner. Unloaded it to Langer. Can they move it quickly? It goes to Fulton Smith. Then to Hagen. The gap was there. It's turned back beautifully. Meninga taken in the tackle. 13 metres out from the New South Wales line. Les Kiss goes to Wallace to dummy half. He'll get it across to Dan Staines. Bullocks his way. He's turned it over. It's Bradley Clyde with the ball for New South Wales. And the crowd love that. New South Wales trying to work it out through O'Connor, but Langer is there and so too is Dan Staines. A lot of pressure now on Queensland to try and pin New South Wales down this end of the ground. They've got plenty of options in the kicking department, New South Wales, and they've used it to good effect. Good ball movement by the Blues. Oh, that's the mistake. Loose on the ground, it's a Queensland ball. So the pressures, David, are starting to come back on New South Wales.
Yeah, they're forcing errors on New South Wales because they're the ones being forced to play inside their own territory. Kick early!
And an interference on Gary Belcher. Has the referee spotted it? He hasn't. And the ball is run out of the in-goal area by Andrew Eddinghausen.
Cannot understand the tactic of Les Kiss there, kicking on about the second tackle. And there was plenty of opportunities. Was it Michael Hagen who put the kick in?
Yeah.
And his opposite number, Laurie Daly, takes play over the quarter line as the cheers go up for the Blues again. And Ricky Stewart drives it. It's a clever kick. Look at the chase by Elias. Back goes our Gary Belcher. He'll feel it just outside his own goal line. And that is a magnificent chase by the New South Wales captain.
Yeah, captain's knocked that from Elias, realising he needed to turn the game around and get Queensland out the other end. He chased hard and did the job.
Well, it's the first time the Blues have been down that end of the ground since the kickoff. And I think Benny was frustrated how much time they were spending inside their own defensive area. So the pressure now on New South Wales, Queensland now to work it outside that danger area, their own quarter line. This has been a frantic pace in the opening round of the State of Origin series for 1990. New South Wales hell-bent on breaking this winning sequence that so far stands at 8 in a row for Queensland. There's the turnover that could be vital. Laurie Daly,
no try. He's called it back. David. He's called for a knock-on, and it could be a very controversial one. Laurie Daly does not believe he knocked it on. The ball came out of the hands of Wally Fullerton-Smith. Let's have a look at it. Bellett passes back to Alan Langer here. There's the pass back to Langer. He searches out for Fullerton-Smith. Now, Fullerton-Smith comes to the line, and there's the pass. Well, he did. I reckon it did come off Laurie Daly's arm. I'd say the referee is spot on, and Daly scoots away to no avail. Queensland breathe another sigh of relief.
And David Manson does not endear himself to 40,000 screaming Blues fans here at the Sydney Football Stadium. He's given the loose head to New South Wales. I can't believe it. Yeah. If Laurie Daly has knocked the football on, that should have been a loose head and feed to Queensland.
That's inexplicable, that one.
Well, to me, if that's the situation, that's a dumb penalty. Danny Staines.
And there's a punch-up as well. Frustration's coming now. Players come to basically break it up.
Absolutely dumb stuff by Queensland, and it's still going on. Benny Elias is in there. This is dreadful stuff.
The penalty has gone to New South Wales, right in front of the sticks for the initial infringement.
But why would he do it, David? They've just got a biggest let-off of all time. They've had the try disallowed, and now they've given New South Wales a certain 2 points.
So I agree, 4-0, and we've seen recently in a number of matches, provocation, players retaliating, players frustrated. The penalty has gone to New South Wales. This could give them the buffer they're looking for. They lead at the moment by 6 points to nil.
Yes, an eight-point advantage, of course, is going to be here. It is again.
He could go for that. It's a definite rabbit killer from Danny Staines.
Dan Staines came right over the top there. The ball was thrown up then at Staines.
It's just been showing Bill on the big scoreboard here too. And the whole blue is being replayed on the big scoreboard.
Well, I noticed David Manson isn't looking up at it, so that's something, I guess.
41,235, a new ground record here tonight at the Sydney Football Stadium, and they've been treated to some unbelievable action. We can do without this, though.
Well, here's referee Manson coming across, and this will be a chance now for Mick O'Connor. 41,235, there's the penalty.
And it is a new ground record because they have introduced some new seating here at the Sydney Football Stadium. There's been sell-out crowds here before, but they have introduced new seating now that has increased the capacity of the ground.
So that'll be Michael O'Connor. And a dead-set two-pointer coming up for him. And that's certainly something that Queensland can do with that.
Yeah, this is right in front. There's the shot from behind the goalpost. Michael O'Connor has these sort of kicks for breakfast. There should be no problem for him to extend the lead to 8 points to nil.
Well, if he hasn't for breakfast, I hope he's had a bad night's sleep.
As he's
don't like the chances, don't you?
No, I think this is bread and butter here for Michael O'Connor. He's kicked one from two at the moment.
So here he is, lining up with it now. New South Wales 6-0. New South Wales 8-0. Through it goes with Michael O'Connor, and play will come back to the halfway mark.
I'm getting that old Forex feeling.
When you've got the taste for a true bitter beer, nothing satisfies like the icy cold bite of a Forex.
You wouldn't want an Iron Man to go rusty.
I can feel a Forex coming on.
So it's New South Wales in possession just short of the quarter line. And as you can see, that buffer, as David Wright said before, of 8 points.
And this crowd really starting to get behind the New South Wales team now.
Well, they might, Bill. They have basically been in control for the majority of this match. Queensland had a glimmer of hope early minutes of the second half, and they had some good attack ball. They'll need to go searching for it again.
Another downtowner here from Ricky Stewart. And Gary Belcher runs back again, looks around. There's plenty of sky blue in front of him, but he flicks it back inside. Les Kiss coming up with it. And he's got to be put down about 20 metres out from his own line.
Worst thing Queensland can do is panic in a situation like this. Though New South Wales are fired up, but Queensland must not give away opportunities or possession in this part of the field.
Just under 27 minutes remaining in the match. New South Wales lead is 8 points to 0. Queensland still camped down inside their own quarter.
But how would you like to be calling shots out there? There's no way the players can hear calls tonight.
No, you wouldn't hear a thing. Here's Alan Langer. They keep it going. This is better. Walters. Walters 10 metres short of the halfway mark. Talking about noise, Tony Duncan, you know what it's like down there. How is it?
Well, they haven't shut up, Bill, from the very first whistle. And, of course, the further New South Wales gets in front, the more noise they make. But they certainly have enjoyed this game tonight. There's no doubt about that.
Yeah, well, you said they didn't shut up after the first whistle. I don't think they'll shut up after the full-time whistle either if this continues.
Offside a mile, Elias.
Here's a kick through now by Gary Belcher. Back there is Ettinghausen. He'll run it out to the quarter. And is put down over there by Bobby Lindner.
He's had a great game, Lindner.
Yes, he's really lifted up to it. This is Ricky Walford, tackled by Lindner. Well, Lindner grabbed him first up, but finished off on the tackle of Walters. So away from dummy half, O'Connor.
Mark McGaugh, after he put a good tackle on Dale Shue a little while ago, slow to get back in the action.
So taking it up over there is David Gillespie. Elias to dummy half. The New South Wales lead is 8 points to 0. The kick downfield again by Stewart. And it's going to be taken by Alan McIndoe. McIndoe decides to run it out. He said, I'll test out this wish-out fellow. And he puts him down. So the dummy half, Hagen. Belcher with a long one across field. It's going to be taken by O'Connor. He gets to the wall and he loses it. Another one bombs.
Another one gone, you're right. New South Wales have had heaps of opportunities, around about 5 now. That one from a drop ball. Queensland starting to panic a bit, throwing those long passes. I'd say the ball is going to be forward to Walford anyway. Knocks it on.
Alan Langer to feed. They're just inside the Queensland quarter. As soon as Belcher let go with that pass, it was
against the head.
Stations, they've got it. Have they? They've lost it to the back of the side.
Well, Ricky Stewart definitely knocked it on, so it should be a loose head and feed to Queensland again.
So, just on that quarter line, 24 and a half minutes remaining. Langer gets it this time. Surinam's warming up. That's Hagen. Hagen, well wrapped up. Coming in over the top, Laurie Daly. And the tackler underneath that time was Bruce McGuire. So, Tony Durkin down on the touchline. There's a couple of players warming up. Lazarus, another one, eh?
Oh, aren't they big fellas too? Paul Surinam and Glenn Lazarus warming up in the tunnel for New South Wales. That's a pretty awesome thought for Queensland.
212 kilos, Bill. Heavy weights to come on.
Leave me out.
And it's good coaching by Gibson too. He knows his side's got the upper hand. He's going to go for the killer punch now. But Queensland are fighting back.
Evaninga gets it outside. That's Dale Shearer. Warford comes in from the wing. He gets it back. McKiss on the bounce. He sets out across field. He's still going. He's not going terribly much forward, but eventually put down 8 metres short of halfway. It is the final tackle, so Wallace is up as dummy half. He swings it away to Langer. They decide to run it at this stage. Keeping it going. Why not? That's Belcher. Kicks it. Bounces off a couple of New South Wales players. Then off a Queensland player.
He's lost it.
And Queensland end up with it again. This is Alan Langer. Well, gee, they've made some mistakes, particularly in strike-scoring opportunities. There's the changeover for the new players. Bella gets it outside. This is Hagen running around, not quite sure where to go. And eventually tackled by Roach.
I think Artie Beetson's got to go with some fresh players. And I think Jack Gibson's beat him to the punch.
This is Martin Bella, taken up there by McGuire. Trevor Gilmeister warming up down to the touchline. Not surprised. McGuire's there again to get Walters. He edges his way inside New South Wales territory, but only just. Langer. Langer doubles around, but is wrapped up once again by that solid New South Wales defence. Final tackle coming up. So back it goes to Belcher. He swings it away over there to Meninga. There's the kick by the centre. Downfield to Ettinghausen. Ettinghausen will run it out. A big long pass coming across over here to Wishart. Wishart starts to stretch out, but a nice tackle coming in underneath by McIndoe. New South Wales on the attack again. Ettinghausen sending it away over to Bradley Clive, but the Queensland defence coming in. Staines leading the way. And eventually finished up over the top by Walters. Laurie Daly wrapped up midway between the quarter and halfway. Still in New South Wales territory. Elias gets it outside to Roberts. Roberts to a couple of metres short of halfway.
Two Tony fresh Durkin. Reserves trying to get on. Here's Tony Durkin.
Two front rowers will be coming off for New South Wales. Steve Roach and Ian Roberts being replaced by Sirinen and Lazarus.
Gary Melcher takes it back there from the kickoff. He's working across field. He can't get away from Elias. Big tackle by the New South Wales captain. And Queensland still down. It's well down inside their own quarter. Dummy half is Walters. He'll send it back to Fullerton Smith. Working up towards the quarter line. There are the reserves waiting to go. Lazarus and Sirinen.
Handling errors 12 by New South Wales and 11 by Queensland.
21, just over 21 minutes remaining in this match. Langer swings it away. This is Lynn Nahi. Dummies. Sends it back inside. Picked up by Shearer. Juggled it well, but McGuire got him. Final tackle. Waiting up as dummy half. Hagen gets it away to Langer. Langer will kick it downfield. Ettinghausen going back, and eventually picks it up close to his own line.
Queensland slow to chase.
Here's Alan Langer coming up at Ettinghausen. Got him. Meninga from the other side. I know which one I want to hit into.
It's a sandwich.
And that's Walford. He's tackled. Langer the man again.
And Ettinghausen was the meat of the sandwich, and not too good either.
I know where most of the damage would have come from. There's the tackle of Dale Shearer coming in.
There's Ettinghausen, and he's in quite a bit of trouble.
So from the play the ball, Elias gets it outside to Roach. He still hasn't left the field. Those replacements waiting. That's Roach getting it up another couple of metres. He'll play it to Elias. Elias back over there to Stewart. Stewart in turn across to Gillespie. Gillespie wrapped up. Tackler once again. In underneath is Alan Langer. Final tackle. And away to Ricky Stewart. There she goes. Cross field.
Gillespie down injured as well, so that may be a revamp in Jack Gibson's thinking now.
Righto, now here it comes, out to Belcher. Belcher got it away from him from Kiss. He's going to be tackled by Bradley Clyde, though. They've chased the ball very well tonight, New South Wales, and Queensland have really had to work to get it away from down their own quarter. Back inside is Hagen. He works across field, looking for a gap. Now sends it over the top. It's over the top of everyone. It's in the touch.
Second time Queensland in the match have been looking for opportunities on the outside. The pass was a wide one.
Tony Durkin, the changes as we look at this in replay. This is the pass that went over the top. The Queensland movement breaks down, and three replacements coming on, Tony.
The two New South Wales players, Lazarus and Sirinen, will still be coming on for the two props, Roach and also Ian Roberts, and Wally Fullerton-Smith's off in the Queensland side. He's been replaced by Trevor Gilmister.
Well, David Gillespie will go up to prop with Lazarus. And the last time Steve Roach was replaced here was in the grand final last year, and he wasn't a happy man, but he's done the job tonight, but he certainly hates being replaced.
Well, he was also in front for Balmain in the grand final, Canberra came back to win it.
There's McGaugher.
He's had a good game tonight.
Well, with Gillespie going up into the front row, that's where he's played the last four matches with Canterbury Bankstown in the Premiership. And he's done that very, very effectively with Canterbury up near the top of that Premiership ladder. So now Wishart will go into dummy half. And the Queensland defence will be tested here. First touch taken upfield by Vic Len Lazarus. Tasted grand final victory here last year. Long pass. The two Canberra players, Stewart and Daly. And a ball knocked down.
And he knocked it on as he tried to pick it up.
Another opportunity it could have been.
Yeah, this was a try. It had written it all over it. Meninga just had to grab that one cleanly. Couldn't handle. It's a knock on by Queensland. Should be loose head and feed New South Wales.
Touch judge on the far side. And referee David Manson, who is he going to call out? He's calling out the two centres, Shearer and McGaugher, who have had a running little battle, Tony Durkin, right throughout this football match.
They certainly have. Fordo, I don't think there was too much in this, just a scuffle between two players, really wanting their sides to win tonight. I think it'll just be a very general caution to both players and on with the game.
Yeah, I think the touch judge is overreacting a bit here. Maybe Mum's in Townsville or somewhere, but not much need to come on here.
Well, David Manson will take no action. The scrum will pack down. It's midway between the half and the 22.
No, yes, I remember my first State of Origin match. Even before the kickoff, I had the cold shakes. But once I'd taken a few quarter poundings, I settled in and lined myself up for a few fries.
So another mistake by Queensland. Here's a chance for the Blues, but it's tidied up by Les Kiss, who brings it back. Six more to go. Kiss into open space, taken in the tackle by Elias. Centre field, Tony Durkin, another change.
Number 15, Kevin Walters. He'll be the third, or the second tonight, the third, of course, to play State of Origin football on for Mick Hagan.
Yes, he made his debut in the third match last year as a replacement. Kevin and Sandra Walters, with Kevin's fiancée Kim Placer, sitting in the grandstand tonight at the Sydney Football Stadium, travelling down from Ipswich. And Steve made the debut in the hooking role tonight, with injured brother Kieran not being able to take his place in the side. So very much the Walters Ipswich connection in this Queensland side. Dan Staines, 5 metres short of the 22. Great running by Staines on that occasion. 16 minutes remain. There's the kick by Langer, over the top, the chase is on. Walford did it well.
Queensland still with a chance to put some defensive pressure on here, got him right in the pocket. There's the tackles, missed tackles, Queensland 22, New South Wales 7.
Well, they did so much work on the tackling bags at Rushcutters Bay yesterday. It was one thing that the team manager, Dick Turner, told me, that they really worked overtime. I wonder whether it's the case, Dave, or they left it on the training paddock.
Well, they may have done quite a bit, but I think you've got to give New South Wales a lot of credit. They've spread the ball pretty well. They've made it hard for Queensland to get an easy mark, and they played the game at a very fast pace.
So Lazarus takes it beyond the quarter line on the final tackle. And as I feared, before the kickoff, the superior kicking game of New South Wales has been a telling factor how much they miss Wally Lewis out there tonight.
That's it, Porto. Not only the New South Wales kicking game has been superior, but Queensland have lacked in that department as well.
Now Meninga, 24 metres out from his own goal line. And I suppose we now must be looking at the prospect of a first in State of Origin football. Well, not really, but I was talking about whether they've been held trialists. They were, in fact, held trialists in that first game in 1985 when Michael O'Connor scored all the points for New South Wales, 2 tries and 5 goals, 18 points to 2 on that occasion. And the only time that Queensland have failed across New South Wales line in a State of Origin game. And they've got around about 14 minutes to correct that. A pass for McIndoe. Can he do it? It's up towards the halfway. Superb defence by Mark McGaw. He took both boots off. A copybook tackle in anyone's language.
Bootlace stuff.
There's the kick downfield. And it's Eddinghausen, who took a heavy knock before. Would he be reluctant to run it up? He's not. He got around Meninga. And Tony Durkin, another change happening.
Kevin Walters still can't get on this field. Gary Coyne, also from Ipswich originally, he'll be replacing the Queensland skipper, Paul Vaughton.
So New South Wales, with 14 minutes of play remaining in the second half, lead by 8-0. They led by 6-0 at halftime. And a stupid penalty by Queensland early in that second half cost them dearly. That's loose on the ground. That's been knocked on by New South Wales.
Well, I thought it may have been touched in flight by Queensland. Some of the crowd disagreeing. Let's have a look at it. The pass up, knocked there initially by Hagan, also knocked by Bradley Clyde. Interesting to see who David Manson decides should have loose head and feet.
Well, the two little halfbacks having a little battle there. There's Paul Vaughton. Replaced the captain of the Queensland side, so I'd say Meninga probably will assume that role now. Langer. Away for... dropped by Kevin Walters on his first touch. Fatal mistake and a coach's nightmare.
Well, it is. Queensland have made some fundamental errors whenever they've had a chance to put some concerted pressure.
Now Bradley Clyde, Kevin Walters took a very, very heavy knock at Tony Durkin. It's a Disneyland stuff.
Absolutely does not know where he is, Kevin Walters. First touch of the ball and he certainly is in Disneyland.
And New South Wales take it 5 metres beyond the halfway line. Walters, the shake of the head. And Sirenin, good ploy by Gibson to bring him on at this stage of the game. Elias, he's broken through one. He's lost the football, and it's dived on by Dale Shearer. Still loose on the ground, tidied up by Les Kiff. Play on. And Bradley Clyde and Sirenin. In fact, it was Daly and Sirenin. Langer out of dummy half. very few breaks made by Queensland, which is a credit to this New South Wales defence, particularly with the tries that were scored against them last year in that series, David. A record score in the last game.
Well, Queensland dictated play in last year's series, but New South Wales very determined in this one. They have been the better side. Queensland have made too many errors.
Well, it's going to set up an absolutely magnificent series because game two is in Melbourne. And then what could be a decider at Lang Park in game number three. It's such a crucial series this year with the Kangaroo Tour hanging on at the end of it. And I remember in 1986, David, the last Kangaroo Tour year, a clean sweep to the New South Wales side, and they in fact then dominated the representation in that touring party.
And that will happen, New South Wales leading 8-0. I think Queensland have tried to kick short far too often in tonight's game. New South Wales have played good sweeping roles, and Queensland have found another way to surrender possession with short kicking.
Well, New South Wales trying to break the Queensland dominance of those games in a row. This is a superb kick. Oh, it's going to go dead in goal.
There's a difference in the tactics. New South Wales have been happy just to kick deep. Admittedly, they've got the 8 points to nil lead, so they can just keep Queensland under pressure. But even prior to having that lead, Queensland, I think, tactically kicked a short too often.
Every picture tells a story. The team manager, Dick Turner, and Wally Lewis. Interesting, Billy, that Dick Turner was complaining that they hadn't made his room up at one of the motels here in Sydney, and that the ball he had at Old Foster Turner was complaining he hadn't had new shampoo in his room.
Yeah, I don't know what's happening. I think a cockroach must have drunk it or something. Tosser would be about half a bottle a year, wouldn't he?
Well, yeah, no, you'd be able to give us a good indication.
Gary Coyne takes it over the halfway line. Queensland trailed by 8-0. It goes across to Walters, then to Meninga. Meninga straightens upfield. And the big man takes it 10 metres inside New South Wales into the ground. New South Wales, 57 possessions in the second half. Queensland, 80, but they haven't turned that into points. Quick ball movement. It goes across field. Now Lindner, back for McIndoe, back for Bella. Bella through the pass across field. Walters, here's a break. But good defence, Daly Langer. He's lost the football. And Bill, is that the last chance for Queensland?
Well, 10 minutes to go, maybe not. Porto. There's the attempted run by Walters. I felt he may have gone a touch too far, although he ultimately did get his hands free. Daly Langer probably should have held it.
Ricky Stewart to feed the scrum, 20 metres out from the New South Wales line. And it's 9.5 minutes to go in the match. New South Wales with that lead of 8 points to nil. That's Laurie Daly, wrapped up there by Walters. Tommy Harp waiting there is McGaugh. To Bradley Klein. A well-drilled New South Wales team tonight here, David.
Yeah, they've been very enthusiastic, Bill. They had a number of opportunities in the first half, couldn't capitalise, but finally got their chance late in the first half.
OK, down there on the grandstand is Wally Lewis. Walter, things don't look too good out there.
No, it's certainly not looking very encouraging at all, mate, for Queensland. It's getting to that stage of the game now with only 9 minutes left where we've got to start taking a few chances, but we've got to make sure that everybody's involved in the move. And we've got to have maximum support we possibly can from every time we run the football. We've got to try and obviously get the ball a little bit wide and attack just on the edge of their flanks, because their forward pack, the New South Wales forward pack, hasn't budged one inch all night long. They've certainly shut us down a fair bit and haven't allowed us one little bit of room to move in defence.
Wally, would you go along with the fact New South Wales have been a pretty well organised outfit out there tonight?
Well, they certainly are, Billy. I mean, the thing that's won them the game for them, or is winning them the game so far, is their defensive pattern. They're spread right across the football field, and every time that our forwards take us up, we have a deep back line, but it's looking that well-drilled, their defensive unit, that our guys just don't have anywhere to run.
Oh, well, even if they get away with it tonight, Walter, there's still a couple more to go, isn't there?
Well, there certainly is, but the pressure's really going to be on us from now on in the remaining two games, should they win this one, and it certainly looks as though they're going to do that. But we're going to have to pick our act up. We've let ourselves down quite a few areas tonight.
All right, thanks, Wally Lewis. So that's Andrew Enninghausen with it now, 25 metres out from his own line. Away from dummy half is Wishart. And 7.5 minutes remaining in the match. That's Lazarus. Dummy half coming up is Benny Elias.
And there were two things that most people were talking about coming into this match, David Wright. One would be Benny Elias, the danger man from dummy half, and the other the kicking of Ricky Stewart. They both come out.
Yeah, you're right, Bill. Benny Elias has played well. New South Wales have been keen.
That's Bradley Clyde. Tackled by Alan Langer. Mal Meninga came crashing in over the top, and he's hurt his knee. He's down at the moment. Ricky Stewart getting it away to Daly. Daly decides to put it up. It's a very, very high one. They're coming at it in all directions. Belcher took it brilliantly. Got it away over there to Shearer. Shearer going to be knocked over. Got up, started to go. He went another. He's still going. Eventually wrapped up midway between the quarter and halfway down in Queensland territory.
What a take from Belcher.
So now it's Bobby Lindner. Yeah, they were putting a pressure. They were flying through on top of him.
Mal Meninga still in trouble. Two trainers attending to him. A knee injury.
So back inside. Alan Langer getting it away then to Staines. So Coyne. And that crunching defence of New South Wales still to the fore. Walters.
There's Mal Meninga being assisted from the field.
So that's all Queensland's reserves are out there, aren't they? No, we've still got Mark Coyne to go, yep. Just as well. Well, he's waiting to go on, Tony.
Mark Coyne is going on. It looks as though Meninga will be coming off, Bill. Mark Coyne in jersey number 14. Of course, no relation to Gary Coyne, who's already out there for Queensland. But it does appear as though the big fella might be staying on. No, he's coming off now.
Well, I suppose if there's any doubt about him, take him off and give him the chance to recover a little bit.
There's young Mark Coyne, makes his debut for Queensland, and what a chance he would have if he could pull maybe a last-minute tryout. There's 5.5 minutes to go. Queensland need possession. They need a runaway.
Benny Elias, the dummy half, back over there to Sirinen. Sirinen wrapped up right on the halfway mark. Dummy half Elias again. There's the kick through. Touch. Gary Belcher back there. But he's going to be wrapped up. Graham Lyons is on the field now for Wishart, so they're giving them all a run. And why not? I suppose Jack Gibson might as well give a couple of these players the opportunity to get used to this atmosphere.
Yes, Bill, he'll be relying on a squad again in 3 weeks' time in Melbourne. And he'd like nothing more than to give a couple of these young fellows a look at State of Origin football.
So the defence coming in once again. That's Lazarus. And also Sirinen, the two replacement players. Working a crossfield over there is Coyne. It's Gary Coyne, of course. So Wallace from dummy half to Alan Langer. Little kick through, going to be taken by Ettinghausen. Slammed to the ground right on the halfway mark. 4.5 minutes remaining. Walford still on the halfway. Dummy half Elias. He's knocked over by Langer but didn't get the pass away. Taken back over there by Gillespie. Gillespie to 10 metres inside Queensland territory. Dummy half McGaw.
He's had a great game, Dave Gillespie.
Clyde, thrown to the ground though. Tackler coming up over there. Was Kevin Walters. Seems to have recovered, Tony.
He seems okay. In fact, he's done two tackles in a row, young Kevin Walters, and he really is getting into his work out there. Unfortunately, though, I think it's a little too late.
Here's a kick right across field, bouncing up high. Going to be taken by Coyne. And a penalty now. Hey, hang on, a flash. Coyne, it was away.
Yeah, premature there, David Manson, in blowing the whistle. I don't think New South Wales held off. I think Coyne had ducked the tackle. And a chance there for Queensland. Coyne easily could have gone a long way. Ettinghausen was the only man who may have come across and covered a fence. Queensland, it has not been Queensland's night with only 3.5 minutes to go. They're down by 8 points to nil. They have frittered away a number of opportunities. The penalties have favoured New South Wales by 9-5.
Tony Durkin.
Well, the last change in this match is being made, and little Jeff Toovey, who looks more like a school kid than a first-class rugby league player, is on for Ricky Stewart.
You're not wrong, Tony. I saw him walking into the ground here tonight, and I thought he'd probably go to the kids' gate and get him for half price.
He makes Alan Langer look like a grandfather.
Alfie won't like that. So just under 3 minutes remaining. And New South Wales with a lead of 8 points to nil. Alan Langer up there as dummy half. Swinging away to Walters. Toovey comes out him, he unloads it. That's Shearer. Toovey continues. And also into the tackle over there is Michael O'Connor. Ooh, they swing it back. Staines ends up with it. This is Belcher. And McGaugh comes at him. Sirenin finishes off the tackle. McGaugh was the one that started him on the back pedal. Here's the final tackle. Alan Langer, rubber kicks through, but Toobie's back there. And he'll get possession for New South Wales. A Lion from dummy half.
I think that last passage of play, Bill, epitomises the urgency that New South Wales have shown tonight. They've been very keen to chase in, to harass Queensland, to give that back line no opportunities. The times that New South Wales have beaten Queensland over the years, Queensland have normally gone in with a better back line on paper. New South Wales have been able to get up quickly and keep them quiet. Daly!
Daly steps inside beautifully. He's got Belcher to beat. He puts in a little kick. It's got to be a try. Oh, it's taken back there by Ettinghouse. Another six tackles. This will put on the pressure. From the play, the ball. Stopping for the line. Going to be a try, I'd say. It'll be Lazarus. Held up. Held up.
Well, great effort from Queensland. We might say they haven't played well tonight, but let's face it, New South Wales have only scored one try. Queensland have fought it out to the end. They were desperate there. Dan Staines on the spot, and so was the referee and David Manson. To hold up Glenn Lazarus is no mean feat.
70 seconds of play remaining here at the Sydney Football Stadium. Queensland have kicked on 23 occasions in general play, New South Wales 21.
Daly's also had a good game. It was expected that Laurie Daly would be a thorn in the side of Queensland. His extra pace and strength has been very effective.
Well, after some of the write-ups I've seen down here, David. They throw it over the top. Coming out this time to McIndoe. McIndoe trying to get away from Lyons. Knocked him off balance. Started going again and down he goes. Some of the write-ups of the Sydney papers as of late have had Laurie Daly as a combination between Batman, Superman and the whole group.
Yes, they've certainly wrapped him strongly, but when it all comes down, he has played well. There was a lot of pressure on him because of those wraps that they put on him, and he's played well tonight.
Alan Langer comes up as the dummy half.
Let's see how he goes up against the King in 3 weeks' time.
So that's Coyne unloads it. Wallace, they keep it going. Lindner right over the top. Coyne, he gets it away outside then to Kiss. Kiss stepping back inside. This is good stuff. They keep it going. Working around with Staines. Staines looks for support. Walters. Walters is going to be put down 25 metres out. He's
knocked it on. Kevin Walters doesn't agree.
There it is. It's all over. New South Wales have won the opening encounter of State of Origin. They've taken the match by 8-0. After they led by 6-0 at the half-time break.
You can see there that New South Wales greatly relieved. They had an 8-match losing streak. They've turned it around tonight by winning by 8-0. They had a point to prove. The coach had a point to prove in Jack Gibson. He suffered a 3-0 whitewash last year. New South Wales decided to go with him, but they decided to go with a selectors team this year. They picked a form team, a very good one, who managed one try and only one try against a Queensland side that didn't play particularly well. New South Wales certainly bombed a few, but they finally got the ball across the line in the 31st minute of the first half. Mark McGaugh it was who finally got it across. But let's be frank here, New South Wales with a better team on the night. Really, Queensland seldom looked like scoring. New South Wales showed greater urgency. They deserved their win, but it is a three-match series. Queensland have a number of players who can come back to bolster their side. They've got a lot of work to do to turn it around, but all in all, New South Wales can feel very proud of their effort.
Tony Durkin's down there in centre field. Over to you, Tony.
Scoreboard, but only one try. A lot about the Queensland performance to like.
Yeah, the desperation was there, Durko, but unfortunately we weren't real sharp in attack. They had a lot of try-scoring opportunities. I think we did well to hold them out for most of the first half, but disappointing still, mate.
It did scramble very well, Queensland. I think they had four tries that went astray New South Wales in the first half, so your defence really was pretty spot on.
Yeah, the defence was good. Although we're a little bit disappointed around the middle of the ruck, I think, at half-time. We realised they were making a lot of yards. We were concentrating a little bit too much on their players out wide. But to our credit, we came back, and I thought we had a few try-scoring opportunities in the second half. And, who knows, if we had got over the line, it might have been a different ball game.
Gary, 2 weeks before the next game in Melbourne, what does Queensland do now to win that game?
Well, Bradley, tough game.
I think there's no problem with the players that are in the side. It's just we've got to change our tactics a little bit.
Well, from your point of view, I suppose you've got to go into that Blues dressing room tonight and congratulate your Canberra teammates. And, of course, you back up with a very important game against Balmain on Sunday.
Yeah, we've got to come together as teammates now, as you said, and try to go back to club football and try to, put all of our concentration into that. It's pretty hard chopping and changing for, over the next few weeks, but it's part of the game. We have to do it.
Belch, we really do appreciate you coming down to talk to us tonight. All the best on Sunday against Balmain and again in Melbourne in a fortnight.
Yeah, thanks, mate.
Back to you, Billy.
And it just soaked up their energy.
So there it is, Gary Belcher here at the Sydney Football Stadium after New South Wales have taken out the match by 8-0. And we'll have the Man of the Match award coming up very shortly. But meanwhile, here's Tony Durkin back down there on the centre field, and he's with Michael O'Connor now.
Well, Michael, it's been a long time between drinks for New South Wales, 8 matches, in fact. A very solid performance tonight.
Yeah, I thought so, Durko. I thought that wasn't it, you know. If anything, I thought the score probably flattered them a little bit. We had a lot of opportunities, which we squandered, particularly in the first half. And, you know, I thought it was a good all-round performance, and congratulations, New South Wales.
Very, very eager, New South Wales. Too eager in the first half?
Well, I think so. I think that's what it was. We were doing things a little bit too quickly, and mind you, Queensland defended well. You can't take that away from their last-ditch defence and cover defence was first class.
OK, Mick, thanks for your time. We'll let you get to the celebration.
Thanks, Dirk. Great time.